Oh, amusement park.
Yes. We go near it.
We already was there.
No, we wasn't.
Once there is a fish place also.
No. That is not different. That's different.
I remember that place we was.
Yes, there. But we was in this side.
Old time train. We call it train, no train. Art. Old time so these small electricity run trains are used for a transportations in a city. Filled with the people. So there is a reflection. We can't see it. Right. Let's try from other direction. So here we can see that in 1973 that was used. Here is the same situation. You can't see it inside. Well, it is nice. So there is one another closer look for that amusement park. Vikings. That is the tallest structure, like a lighthouse. On a roof there is a restaurant which always keep rotate. Well, what a marvelous view. Okay, now we are about to go a museum of labor. Art is something that we always need an eye to understand it, and some things I don't understand, but definitely they could have a meaning also. So in the beginning of museum, they just give us that kind of gadget. It's like a audio device. So it will help us a tour to that museum. Let's begin. CD painting. So there we find the same gadget, and let's start with it. Okay, nice. So all these flowers are handmade. Well, so basically it's all art paintings. So again, let our guide speak. Well, that gadget is really nice, so it's help us to know everything. This is so beautiful. In this, the artist represents the curtain. small curtain. From there you can see outside the window, sunshine in a snow. Marvelous.
Dresses of queens. The corona pandemic offered her extra time to create something new. Thus, the title of the series refers not only to royal crownings, but also to the pandemic. This feminist series deals with women in positions of leadership. The subjects include the coronation of Charlotte as Queen of Great Britain and Ireland in 1761. Charlotte was well educated, and her interests included botany and music. She founded orphanages and promoted measures for the improvement of women's health. Art is characterized by elements that are considered to be feminine, such as lace and decoration, lipsticks and high heels. Her art has often been described as beautiful. Beauty in art is sometimes easily dismissed, and a beautiful picture may be considered superficial and commercial. Lehinen has striven to show that art can be decorative and still worthy of being taken seriously. She hopes that through her art, she can offer the viewer an opportunity for enjoyment and pleasure. Lehinen is fascinated by laborious and meticulously exact working methods. As an artist, she regards herself above all as an artisan. Most recent works, Osmo Rauhala has explored the thematics of the so-called mirror self-recognition test. Self-recognition is the first stage of consciousness. It has been demonstrated by means of the mirror test that the ray is the only fish that recognizes itself from a mirror image. Consciousness, or the comprehension of oneself as an observer, can be regarded as the opposite of narcissism. In the familiar myth, Narcissus sees a mirror image of himself in a pond and falls in love with his reflection without ever being able to reach it. The Narcissus of the Sea paintings are connected with a series of works by Rauhala using the sea ray as a subject and the symbolism associated with it. They depict squids which, unlike rays, are incapable of recognizing themselves. The association between squids and Narcissus came to Rauhala when he imagined vain squids looking at themselves in mirrors that they held in their tentacles.
Seuraavassa näyttely rakennan jotain sellaista, mitä olen aiemmin tehnyt, hyvin isot teoksen, normaalisti pystytty ja pienempi ja siitä parista.
He's mad at me.
Dark works depicting soldiers and skeletons, black paintings. Under a Harsh Sky continues in the same spirit. The skull also links the work to the Vanitas tradition, symbolizing the transience of life in the history of art. The artist has stated, "I'm satisfied with the expression and the material feeling of the work, its granular quality and transparency. I strive for clarity and at the same time, mystery." A large work is viewed from a distance, but close up, one discerns the various material gestures. They can produce physical sensations. When I pass my hand over the surface of a painting, it is as if I was stroking the wrinkled skin of an old granny. For me, a work is a gentle reminder that everything has its time.
That is true. Everything has its time.
Silence is golden, it is said. On the other hand, muteness can be poisonous. Salkonen explores the difficulty of expression, reticence, and submissive confidentiality in this series, the practice of keeping silent, to which these large paintings belong. An endless stave of music structures empty orchestra. On the stave, instead of notes, are footprints. Such marks already appeared in cave paintings as signs of human presence. In the brain-shaped speech bubbles of loud silence, there are crossed lines which may depict deleted expressions and internal censorship. For Salkonen, the materials he uses and physicality constitute an important starting point for working. The paint itself is a message. The different traces it leaves speak to arouse feelings. The large size of the work alone can produce a physical experience. The fact of pain is the sensory perception of pain and movement in an amputated limb. It's not just a product of the imagination, but can come from the nerves that were connected to the lost limb. Phantom pain is also a kind of longing. A person can feel longing for someone who no longer exists. In Rawala's work Phantom Pain, the internationally familiar Red Cross symbol is accompanied by a mark created by the artist that can be interpreted as symbolizing pain or an amputated limb. For Osmo Rauhala, art is a medium of communication, among others. It's a way of understanding and analyzing the surrounding reality and phenomena connected with the animal world and humanity. Language is an important form of giving order to things, but alone, it's not enough to explain the different nuances of existence.
Okay. Good thing is that they give us that digital system.
To the philosopher Plato, the circle was the most perfect form and the one that most resembled itself. Therefore, the cosmos too is circular. In the Middle Ages, a circular painting was called a tondo. The circular form as a subject has fascinated Ilka Bagni for a long time, and there are several circular paintings in his oeuvre. Colors too have always been important for him. The basic colors, red, blue, and yellow, recur in many of his works. The artist recalls seeing a wall decoration on a study trip to Egypt in 1989, which was the inspiration for Cairo. The circular wall decoration was located high above a
pyramid. Okay.
I have made this blank with puffy paper.
Okay, so it's all paper. That a star is made from paper.
That.
when nature is happy in that time, leaves can also look like a flowers. So it was a nice time in a museum. There is a wall of stones made by hand. Every single stone is very accurate. Peace to those who sacrificed their life to make today's better. That is a remembrance of World War I, when Nazis used gas attack to survive the gas attacks. People use masks. Here is a amusement park, but because of COVID-19 it's closed. We will be there when it's open.